sense, the divine is with you, because we hold you by your word. And the word says, even if you die, I will raise you to life. Because you have risen from the grave, we are having this blessed assurance in our heart. The divine is with you. And we have no fear, no doubt about this. And we take this moment to say, Jesus, thank you that you came down for us and given us this divine hope that whosoever believeth in you shall not perish but have eternal life. And I thank you, God, for this young soldier of yours who has now the rest of eternity with you, Lord. He's not going to sorrow anymore. He's not going to have to do anything else but to celebrate you the rest of his eternity. And we thank you for it, O God. Upholding the parents and Leona, God, and the rest of the cousins who are in this house. Holy Father, we ask you to give them your peace which the world can never give them. Jesus, please, I ask you in the name, your name, give them your peace which you said, I have come to give you my peace. Not as the peace of this world, but your peace. I believe this afternoon, God, as we, family of Ryan, come together and say, Father, please give the family thy peace, which no one can give. And Lord, you taught us this prayer. If we come in agreement and ask anything unto you in your name, it will be granted by the Father. And this afternoon, wonderful afternoon, oh God, I'm asking you, God, to give Ryan's parents and his sister and their cousins, oh God, your peace. God, you said in the book of Matthew 11:28, I will come and take your burden, whatever burden they may be having right now, God, because of this great loss. Lord, you said, I will take up your yoke and I will give you my yoke. I pray this afternoon to you, my God, in Jesus' name, that God, you would give them your, give this family your yoke, which is of joy and peace in the Holy Spirit. Let that peace, which is from you, O God, through the power of your Spirit, abide and be with them the rest of the journey till they also, and we also, meet you in the eternal glory of your kingdom, O God. So, Father, I thank you. God, take away this emptiness, the sorrow from their heart, and let the joy of the living God begin to gush out of them according to your words from Psalm, from John 7:28, O God, 35, O God. For you said, come to me and I will give you the rivers of living water which will flow out of you. Let that river of life, of joy begin to flow out of this family, O God. Father, they are representing you. They gave your son for your kingdom, O God. And I thank you, God. He fought the good fight, O God. He has done his course and now he is with you, Lord. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. And Father, even as we thank you for his life, we also thank you for this beautiful family, Lord. Let the joy and the peace and your glory always be with them. And Lord, as we proceed from your God, let the grace of our God and the comfort of the Lord be with each one of us. In Jesus' name I pray. And in Jesus' name I choose to thank you, God, because you are a good God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Hello. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear friends, we are here for a reason. We are here to pray and to comfort and to get consoled. Life is a journey, and only the God is the author of our life. And it is a sad reality that all of us have to end this journey of this world and have go back to the world where we belong forever. As Christians, we have faith that our journey, which begins from our mother's womb to the bigger mother, the Mother Earth, to her womb, then to the heavenly blossom, to be forever. Mascarenhas family has added another angel, a young angel in the form of Ryan Mascarenhas, into the heavenly blossom. That God may give our brother Ryan Mascarenhas the joy of happiness forever. And let us pray in a special way for Melvyn, his father, Juliet, his mother, and Leona, his sister, and all the members of this family. Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation. He comforts those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. Let our response be, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord Jesus, the Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where He gives me repose. Near restful waters, He leads me to revive my drooping spirit. Your response, Lord, remember me in your kingdom. He guides me along the right path. He is true to His name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and with your staff. With this you give me comfort. Your response?
Lord, remember me.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of your foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Your response?
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Your response?
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayers and be merciful to our brother Ryan Mascarenhas, whom you have called from this life. Welcome, Ryan, into the company of your saints in the kingdom of light and peace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear friends, as a family, the first prayer of our funeral service that we are praying together, Melvyn, Juliet, Leona, and our brother Ryan has prayed together as a family, and today this full family, the last time we prayed with them, that God may be the consolation and guide, the support and the sustenance. It's not so easy to accept the death of the young person, not only to the family, but the larger family, the community, and the society. In our prayers, let us remember our brother Ryan. So beautiful and graceful and handsome he was. And in the heavenly abode, definitely like an angel, roaming around, making the lives of those who are there happy and sending blessings upon this Mascarenhas family. Placing all the prayers for Melvyn, Juliet and Leona and for the entire family, let us pray the very prayer that Jesus himself taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Mama Mary, be their mother. You know the pain of losing your own son. Same comfort and solace give to this Mascarenhas family as we pray together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Father, God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy for us, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Show compassion to your people in their sorrows, especially Melvyn, Juliet, Leona, and the entire family of Mascarenhas. Be their refuge and their strength to lift them from the darkness of this grief to the peace and the light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us, conquered death and rising again, restored life. May we then go forward eagerly to meet him, and after our life on earth, be united with our brothers and sisters, where every tear will be wiped away. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear friends, here we end the first rite of the funeral. So I kindly request those who are not family members, please get down to the basement, give little bit time to the family. And from here, the mortal remains will be taken to the basement for the final view to the people. So I request kindly go and don't make much because we don't have sufficient time.
Any family members, which are remaining, or need to get down? my daughter in the world. Last one. Sweet.
Thank you.
success.
Thank you. Jitu. Jitu. Jitu.
The question at hand, please switch off your mobile phones. Thank you.
Thank you. your hymn books to hymn number 56, Cause Me to Come, hymn number 56.
Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we have gathered here around this Eucharistic table to pray for the soul of Ryan and the death of Ryan surely brought sadness and pain to all of us, especially to this parish community and to their family members, his dad, Melvyn, his mom, Juliet, and his sister, Leona, and his friends, dear and near ones, relatives. At this time, let us pray that God may help them to bear the loss of their beloved. God granted him a short span of life, and Ryan has begun his journey towards the heavenly land where there is no more death, and all of us have to prepare ourselves to that heavenly land, to prepare ourselves for that journey. And let us therefore ask for God's pardon and forgiveness, that we too, like Ryan, may see God face to face in heavenly abode. God has given and he has taken away. Blessed be the name of God. The words of Job, let these words of trust and faith, let us participate in this Eucharistic celebration, believing that God may grant eternal rest to our beloved Ryan. Now to prepare ourselves in a worthy manner to participate in this Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's pardon and forgiveness. Let us together say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Ryan, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, and the former things have passed away." And who was seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have the heritage, and I will be their God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord. Let our response will be sung.
Hymn number 366, "The Lord is my shepherd." 366.
Gospel according to John. At that time, Mary, the sister of Lazarus, when she came to where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet, saying to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and greatly troubled. And he said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus wept. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man also have kept this man from dying?" Then Jesus, deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, by this time there will be an odor, for he has already been here 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, "Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. I knew that you are always here, but I said this on account of the people standing around, that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said all these things, he cried out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The man who had died came out, his hands and feet bound with striped linen, and his face wrapped up with a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go." Many of the Jews, therefore, who had come with Mary and had seen what he did, believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, my dear Melvyn, Juliet, and Leona, perhaps this is the most difficult time, and perhaps we are waiting to hear what will Father Jerry say at this time. Surely, Father Jerry would have never liked to come back to this parish and celebrate this Eucharist, seeing a young boy who was in his class for confirmation, who is no more able to come running and say to him, "Hi, Father Jerry, how are you?" I'm sure if he had seen me now, he would have been coming running and asking me, "Hi, Father, how are you?" As Ryan, that all of you know, was smiling, always jovial and full of life. But we are faced with this situation when we see and we are not able to see Ryan will before us for the last time as we will bid him the final adieu. Many people asked me when I was in Bangalore, when I told them about this, "Father, what are you going to say? How are you going to speak to the mom and dad and the sister of Leona?" I was seeing a video in which I saw, in the terrible earthquake that took place, a picture of a father who is caressing the fingers of his daughter for the one last time, mourning her death, which the father refusing to let go the hand of his beloved daughter. The only thing that was visible after the horrible rubble that had fallen on this young girl. The father cannot see the body, nothing is visible, but the only thing that is visible is the hand of a daughter on the mattress, and the father is not willing to let go this hand of this daughter. He's sitting in the freezing cold, and amid this pile of debris that are all around him, he can imagine this girl whom he loved so much, whom he brought up in love, is no more. And he requests this photographer to take the photograph, the last pic of their memory. And the photographer, a very veteran photographer, says, "For the last 40 years of my career, among all the photographs that I have taken, this remains as the most difficult experience of my life, clicking this heartbreaking picture, but this was the smallest gesture that I could do to this family." My dear brothers and sisters, I woke up on the Sunday morning hearing this devastating news that our young boy Ryan is no more. And immediately my heart went out to their family. I recollected the picture of his mom, Juliet, sister, and the house. And the thought that came next to me is that I will see next time Ryan with his eyes closed, devoid of his radiating smile that he always had, the cheerfulness that made me to ask this question, and what would have Jesus said to these people who are dealing with such a horrible loss in their life. And only one thing that came to my mind again and again was this verse from the Bible, what we heard today in the Gospel. The shortest verse in the Bible consists of just two words. And the shortest verse in the Bible is this, that Jesus wept. We may ask ourselves this question, and you are sitting to know from me today asking this question: what do I say in this time? How should I respond in a time like this? I stand here as a minister of God, and I realize that some of you expect me to give you answers. Some of you may ask me, Father Jerry, what now? And how do you explain this? My dear brothers and sisters, we live in a world which can give us answers to every question. But the one question which no one can give us an answer to is how long we are going to live our lives. We never know how long will be our lifespan and how many days and months and years we will live. But one thing we know for sure, that we all will have to one day say goodbye to this place, and we'll have to go back to a place where God has destined us to be forever with Him. When we hear in the Gospel, when we see Jesus before these two sisters, Martha and Mary, who are weeping and asking Him this question, that Jesus, if you were here, our brother would have been alive. In the Gospel we have heard, we read, Jesus was deeply moved in His spirit and greatly troubled, and Jesus wept. He who knew Him, and the very next sentence tells us, Jesus wept, so the Jews said, see how He loved Him. We can ask ourselves this question: did God not love us enough? Did we do something wrong? Have we fallen short of grace? But the Gospel tells us that Lazarus was sick. Lazarus was not well, and yet Jesus loved him. He was the friend of Jesus. A young boy, Ryan, was definitely also a friend of Jesus. For when he was born 20 years ago into this family of Juliet and Melvyn, they brought him to the door of the church to be baptized as a little young baby boy who brought joy into this family. And this same boy grew into the church in his faith, in knowing Jesus and loving Jesus. And I had the opportunity to spend some time and some part of my life with this boy when he was growing as a young boy during his confirmation classes. When we had gone for the retreat in the confirmation class, one evening we have a prayer service in which we remember and recollect. All the youngsters who are here will remember that prayer service in which all of us had gathered around a small miniature of a type of a coffin, in which we were asked ourselves, if suppose death comes to us, what is it and who will be there around you to cry? And all the young people were remembering everyone whom they loved, remembering their mom and dad, their brothers and sisters, their friends, their loved ones, who will miss them. And they were asked this question: what will you say to them when you see them no more? And then at that evening night, we remember all of them shedding their tears and recollecting, thinking that yes, they have to go back and say sorry to so many people for their not listening, for their mistakes that they have done. They want to go and hug their mom and dad and say, we love you. And that is how I knew this boy. I knew him coming running in this confirmation retreat, expressing the joy that he had that he was going to be confirmed in Christ, and knowing the fact that I as a confessor sat and even listened to many of the confession of these young people. And so much so that I had tears in my eyes when I listened to that. And I asked my spiritual director, Father, I also cried along with these people when they were sharing with me their troubles and anxieties. Was I too weak? Is the question that I asked my spiritual director. Was I too weak as a priest that I also shed tears along with them? And my spiritual director directed me to these words from the Bible, which told us, Jesus wept. My dear brothers and sisters, We have a God who just doesn't sit in the throne and who is looking at us and who is just sitting there doing nothing. No. We have a God who also died on the cross, who rose again. And we have a God who also wept. And therefore I strongly believe that Jesus also weeps with us today when he knows that this little boy of ours, Ryan, with whom we lived, is no more today with us. But yet we stay in hope, the same hope with which we have grown, that we all will one day have to wind up our life here and go back to God. And the only thing that we have to face and answer God is how well do we live our life. Every death reminds us that we are not going to live here forever. One day we all will return back and see God face to face. When we go and see God back, may we have an answer to tell him how well we have lived our lives. And my dear brothers and sisters, since our life is so very short, we may ask this grace from God that we may live it well and that we may be able to tell God that yes, in our life, we loved him well. My dear brothers and sisters, remembering Ryan and what he must be perhaps speaking to us now, I found this beautiful poem which reads, "Remember me when I am gone away, gone far away into the silent land, when you can no more hold me by the hand, nor I half turn to go, yet turning to stay. Remember me when no more day by day you tell me of our future that you planned. Then that you should remember and be sad. Only remember me, you understand. It will be late to counsel then or pray. Yet if you should forget me for a while, and afterwards remember, do not grieve. For if the darkness and corruption leave a vestige of the thoughts that once I had and all the memories along with me, better by far you should forget and smile." As we bid our final farewell and adieu to Ryan, we thank God for the gift of this young boy whom the Lord had blessed into this family of Juliet and Melvyn and Leona. And we ask God for the consolation to this family, who will know that they may be strengthened in their faith and not weakened, that Christ still lives and is able to still give us the hope that one day when we all finish our life here, we also may be able to see God face to face in faith and trust and confidence.
Number 242, lose yourself in me. Hymn number 242.
And you will find new life.
pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Ryan, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity,
together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy, remember your servant Ryan, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Holy Communion is for baptized Catholics only. Brothers and sisters of other faith are requested to remain seated and join in the singing. Krist Prasad Sir Isai Bhai Behno Ke Liye Hai. Anya Dharmo Ke Logo Bhai Behno Se Nivedan Hai Ki Wo Aage Na Aaye Aur Bhakti Geet Mein Bhaag Lein.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Ryan may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated. Father Brian would like to speak to us, and then there will be presentation, and also there will be a few of them who would like to give the eulogy. Please do come.
my dear friends, my dear fathers, mothers, Deacon Ivan, I stand here on behalf of the Salesians of Don Bosco to offer my sympathies to the family of Ryan, as also the extended family who will miss him so very much. With me, also three of our Salesians from three of us from Dominic Savio's, Father Godfrey, who's come from Manarla, as also the teachers and his batchmates. It is so nice to see so many people here this afternoon to bid farewell and to pray for Ryan and the family. I came to Dominic Savio's in the year 2017 as the rector there. And Ryan was in the 10th standard. He completed in the year 2017-18. I taught them religion, the religion classes that we had thrice a week. One of the things that struck me about him is smiling and very respectful. What further caught my attention is, on his birthday, you know, we have boarding for poor boys and orphans and boys from other families. But on his birthday, he would come to sponsor dinner for the boys. You know? Then he would come now and then with his old clothes for the poor. His mummy also would visit. I was told by Father Godfrey, who is here with us. You know, Father Godfrey was the rector when Ryan was in the primary. He said, even as a little boy, no, his mummy would sponsor, his parents would sponsor one of the poor boys there. So we come here with a lot of gratitude to say thank you to this wonderful family, as he also bid adieu to Ryan, a boy who was very nice, respectful and kind. We also pray for all of you. The good Lord bless all of us.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Yuan, and I'm a friend of Ryan. And I just want to thank God, first of all, you know, that I've got an opportunity to speak today about my friend. And I want to thank Ryan's parents for giving me this opportunity again. And, you know, just one thing about Ryan. Firstly, you know, Ryan and I, we've been friends from the time I was in the second grade, and I'm 2 years older than him, but we've been in the same school, same society, we are part of the same church, same parish. We also were blessed and we served the same ministry, and just, you know, one thing that comes to my mind whenever I think about Ryan is how helpful he was and the kind of person he was. He was always there for you. He was always there for me, and whoever has really been close to him or has spent some amount of time with him knows that he was the kind of guy who would leave everything for you. And just to, you know, just to give you a gist of the kind of helpful person he is, yesterday when we were planning this poster that that you guys can see here, my friend Sagar, he told me, you know, Yuan, you'll have to go and collect it in the morning. And I may or may not be there because I might, you know, be going to office. And the first name that came to my mind, I was like, you know, Sagar, you don't worry, I'll get someone. And the first name that pops to my mind is Ryan. And then, you know, so that's the kind of guy he was. And my spiritual mentor, Dr. Ronnie Parakal, he requested me to speak, you know, today, especially to speak about Ryan's involvement with the kingdom of God and with the ministry, because I believe that that is something that many of us over here, even his closest friends, may not really know about. And that got me thinking as to, you know, what exactly am I going to speak? What? Because I'm just 2 years older than him and I'm not really, you know, very holy or pious or whatever. Whatever I have, whatever I am, it's all by the grace of God. So I just was going through our chats, you know, I was like, I'll open WhatsApp and I'll just check, kuch to baat kya rahe ho uske saath. And I just scrolled, you know, right up from 2016-2017 chats, and a lot of conversations are, you know, all rubbish and, you know, just banter between two friends. But a lot of similar conversations that were repeated from 2017-2019 was, hey Ryan, you have to go and get the chairs for Bible study. Or that is me messaging him, or there is a message from him. And I just went through that, and that kept coming, you know. We have Bible study every week that happens in Dr. Ronnie's house. It used to happen right back from a long time, and right now it's like moved online. But at that point, it used to happen at his house. So I think 2016-2017 was the time both Ryan's parents had encouraged him and, you know, pushed him and told him, you better go for Bible study. And the same thing happened in my house, and that's why we used to go. And we were given a small responsibility to just collect chairs, you know, from the society office on the top and get it to uncle's place. So right from 2017 to 2019-20, that is the only involvement we had in the kingdom of God, okay? And if you see these photos right now, and I don't know if you guys watched the video, there was an audio problem, but there was, there was a clip of him in a camp. And there were some photos, if you see over here, again of him in the camp. And then there was a picture of him at Kamatipura. So right in this last, you know, last 2 years, I've seen how God has moved in his life, you know, right? Just from being a person who used to just come and collect chairs and keep chairs, God has used him. God has used him to enter a place like Kamatipura, you know, where no one goes for, you know, a good purpose. Everyone goes for fulfilling the desires of their flesh, but we were there and we got a chance to minister the gospel to more than 200-250 plus women and men, as well as children over there. And Ryan was at the fore center because he played the role of Jesus in a skit that we had. Also, we had a camp recently, just I think 6-7 months back, and again it was a youth camp. And me, Ryan, we are not people who are on the stage a lot. We prefer being, at the background or whatever. But he got a chance over there to preach, you know, in front of the 30-40 youngsters. And these 30-40 youngsters are all extremely talented and highly blessed people and super talented and always helping him, like, you know, in the church and all that. So it was an honor to listen to him speak. And What breaks my heart the most, it's not the fact that he's passed away. It's the fact that I was growing with this guy in the kingdom of God, and in the last 1 year, I've seen, you know, how God has picked us up, like literally skyrocketed us from just small ordinary guys to, you know, being on stage and doing things that I still don't imagine that I'm doing right now. And it breaks my heart because the gospel says, the word of God says that, you know, each and every one of us has a purpose, is ordained by Christ. We are sanctified in our mothers, before we were formed in our mother's womb. And that is the kind of calling that each one of us have. And because, and it sucks that just before Ryan could fulfill his calling, I believed he had a great calling because the word of God never lies. And I did not get to see him fulfill that calling because of a small mistake that happened. And I believe that, you know, it could easily be me or anyone sitting over here who could have faced that same accident, you know, but we are here only by His grace. And I saw a lot of youngsters today cry and weep at our society. And just one thing, you know, if you really did care about Ryan, if you really loved Ryan as a brother, as a friend, let this be a reminder, let this be an eye-opener for you to reconcile with God today. And there might be areas in your life where you're screwing up, you know, even though you know you're sinning and you're still doing it, just ask God to help you in those areas and reach out to men and women of God, you know, because the kingdom of God is not short of warriors. The kingdom of God is not short of people to mentor you. You just need to have that heart to, you know, heart to turn back to God, heart to lean back to God. So that's all that I wanted to share. And I call my brother Ruben now to just speak a little more about Ryan.
Good evening, everyone. There's a picture on Ryan's feed, his Instagram, which says Ryan Mascarenhas 20. A shark in the water, he swim with a little fish. And I think we all would agree that he is a shark. He was a shark. Looking at the kind of friends he had, looking at the kind of people he's met, and looking at the kind of places he's been to. And you all might agree, he'll come with that smile. Smoke, you know. Hi, what's up? He's always like that. You never see him angry. I don't think there's anyone who's seen him angry over here. There's anyone. So, in his post, he writes this caption, keeping it simple. And when Jaden replies, will you be my Valentine? Well, one part of him, you may all know that he's always fun-loving and always bubbly. But I've seen that side of him, which is crying on his knees and praying for the grace of God. That's the side that no one has seen. And that's the side that there's a picture over here which was Ryan playing the part of Jesus. And there's also a picture where Jesus is the bridge between us and Him and God. And right now I can say with surety that He has crossed that bridge and He is with our Maker. And not many of us can say that. And I'm sure that if He was here, we would ask Him, Ryan, why? He'd smile and say, keeping it simple. So, let us not remember him for these last few tragic moments. Let us not remember him as that guy who passed away in the bike accident, but let us remember him as a light that he was to everyone in this place. He was a light. And he didn't owe us many sorries, but we owed him a lot of thank yous. Thank you.
Anybody crying right now, I request you all not to. Today I stand here bidding farewell to my brother, celebrating him. Even though we used to fight more than talk like normal siblings, there was always a sense of care, love and security in him. Now I wonder who I'll fight with. Wonder who I'll fight with and wonder who'll come in the night asking me, please open the door. Sending me a cat, giving me a flower, saying, this is for you, come and open the door, I'm waiting outside. Mosquitoes are biting me. You want me to get dengue? And my only reply and my mom's reply to him would be, dengue, mosquitoes don't come in the night, they come in the day. I wonder who'll complain to my parents saying, she's wearing my clothes, She's using my perfume. Tell her not to. Ryan was his jolly soul, who even though would be upset himself, would never let the opposite person be upset. He'd always be there standing, saying, "It's okay, it's gonna be all right. You don't have to be upset." He'll be there for you. And you have made us very proud in whatever you have accomplished in life. There's always going to be this void. Since you've left us, I cannot fill that void of yours. But I can try my best. You even did promise me the day you left a rose and a chocolate for Valentine's. But since you cannot fulfill the promise yourself, I will be there every Valentine's to give you the rose and the chocolate. I love you more than words could ever say. You'll always be my sun, my moon, and my stars. So I know that you are always there, standing by my side, protecting me, like you are right now. Even if you have gone today, you will forever be in our hearts. I love you always and forever. Grateful and thankful for all the memories. They will always be loved and cherished by each one of us. We will be having a month's mind mass on the 13th of March, 2023 for the soul of my brother, Ryan Mascarenhas. Thank you.
Dear friends, it is true, always it is hard to accept the death of a young boy, a youth, energetic youth. It is just 1 month past I came to this parish and I heard this news. Of course, it was heartbreaking and it was difficult. And however, it is God's will and God has taken him away. And the sad thing that we have lost a young, energetic, enthusiastic youth of this parish. And at this moment, I want to show solidarity with Ryan's family. Just to say that we are with you. Whole parish committee is with you, praying for you. And also I take this opportunity to thank the fathers who have come here to celebrate this Eucharist and pray for the soul of Ryan. And you, my dear friends, the parishioners and people of other parish too, who have come here to pay your last respect to Ryan and show solidarity with Ryan's family and being consolation and praying for the family. Thank you. Now we shall have the final rite. Then after the final rite, please be seated. I'm sure many of you would like to show your final respect at this, at the coffin to Ryan. Therefore, I would request the people from the end will come in line and go to the coffin, then go to the entrance and go out. The ushers, please help them to follow the discipline. Thank you.
Let us all stand. With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother Ryan to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Saints of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Father, into your hands we commend our brother Ryan. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our brothers and sisters forever. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Let us
We have been taking Ryan to Our Lady of Health of Sahar. If anybody needs to would like to come, we have a list of buses. They will be waiting outside.
stand here, keep looking out, please. You can stand outside.
Thank you.
Can you stand on the stairs, some of you? Stand on the stairs there. Illila Vairosa, public ethical. Illila Vairosa. Staircase is it all. You can also go. Can you give some gaps, please? Thank you. the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they like you will rise again. Give our brother Ryan peaceful rest in his grave, until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise him up in glory. And may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Since Almighty God has called our brother Ryan from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our brother Ryan to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise him up on the last day. Let us pray for our brother Ryan, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer. Our brother Ryan was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at your table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give our brother Ryan eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother Ryan to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Ryan was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother Ryan. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now together say the same prayer which Christ our Savior has taught us. Lord, listen to our prayers for our brother Ryan. As he always desired to do your will, so in your mercy forgive whatever wrong he might have done. By his Christian faith, he was united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy, give him a place in your angels and saints. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Give him eternal rest, O Lord.
Oh, my God.
that, then can you all hold it? This is the immediate standing image. Yannick. Because we're moving from this side.
Thank you. Thank you.